morning, Captain. Good morning, son. That's the first song that I ever did, well, Jack and I ever did together. This guy, Jack Elliott, Ramblin' Jack Elliott, came out from New York. And he was an old buddy of Woody's. He traveled around with Woody. But Frank Hamilton and different ones come knocking on my door, and I must get up to Topanga to see this guy from New York, a guitar player, la 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 la.
I heard stories about Derroll Adams. The great Derroll Adams. The mysterious Derroll Adams. The old man of the mountains lived in a cave. All summer long I heard these stories about Derroll Adams.
And I was introduced to Jack, you know, I had nothing to do. They insisted, we gotta get up on the stage together. I'd never heard him, I didn't know what he did, I had nothing.
I recognized him immediately just from stories. I walked up, I said, "You're Derroll Adams." He says, "Yep." I said, "You have your banjo with you?"
"Nope."
"Well, Bess Hawes has a banjo. Maybe we could borrow Bess's banjo. Would you play on Bess's banjo?"
"Don't see why not."
So we went up, and when we were going up, I said to Jack, "Do you know Mule Skinner Blues?"
"Yep."
Well, we were, you know, by this time our conversation was getting along so well. I knew that we were going to be friends for life.
Good morning, Captain.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, Captain. Good morning, sir. Do you need
I heard Jack Elliott and Derroll Adams play together, and I thought that they had been playing together for months and months or years and years because they sounded so good together. I found out afterwards they had only met the week before.
He met this movie actress. They fell in love, and so they were going to get married. And I was best man at the wedding. I played my banjo, the wedding music.
Darryl took the song "Rake and a Ramblin' Boy" and he wrote some special words to it, with the idea being that he was going to change it slightly so that Jack was getting married, he now found him a pretty little wife, and he wasn't going to rake and ramble anymore.
And now I found me a pretty little wife, ever dearer than I love my life.
At that time, back in the 50s, it was one of the most, probably one of the most wonderful times I ever had. And these wonderful, beautiful people I met.